Hello everyone, it's Dimitri, Immigration Mentor, and today I want to share with you my insights after living a whole year in the west coast of the South Island of New Zealand. I will tell you in this video why I moved there in the first place, where I lived before, what my total impressions from the whole year been there, and why I left. So stay till the end and please subscribe and share this video if you liked it. Let's begin. Back in 2020 January, I just came back from long trip in overseas. I've been in Europe and Ukraine and exploring the life living there, and oh, all this area is flooded. Phew. Yeah, so I explored the life over there. Yeah, so I come back to New Zealand after a few months overseas, exploring Europe, and then I come back to New Zealand January 2020. And also came back with almost no money because I made nice investments for my future. So I came back originally to Auckland. And Auckland, And I came back as you know, as usual. I came back, usually I quit my work because no work most of the time allows me to go on holiday for months and months and months. Usually in New Zealand you need to work, you take 1 month holiday. I'm taking a lot more. I won't take 4 and 5 months. For me that's all right to go overseas and explore and do whatever. So that's what I've been doing the last years while in New Zealand. So I'm taking at least 4 or 5 months every year to spend some time in other countries, because I love it. Anyway, so I came back to Auckland, and I began working there in a crisis team. So it's called like Community Mental Health Crisis Team. And back then I made very good money. And even during the lockdown I made the best money I ever had. And that was a weird period because, you know, a lot of chaos happening in the world. And lockdown in New Zealand, but I didn't expect anything like that since I immigrated. I remember that it was a big shock when we went to the food store to buy groceries, and there was limited one package of vegetables, frozen vegetables per person. And I kind of thought, that's quite weird. And as a consequence, I thought I wanted to have be in an area where I'll be more safe. So it means I needed to be in an area where less people, less population, more remote, more options to grow your own food and vegetables, and that was more more safety, you know. Plus I also heard some rumors about the West Coast. South Island, that it's a very bad place or very good place. So I said, I'll just go and explore for myself. I don't need to hear about any place for rumors. I'll just go and check. Anyway, so I went to the West Coast. After the lockdown lifted to level 2, so I took my chance, stopped my work, and moved to the West Coast. Of course, after few months of traveling and enjoying New Zealand, as usual. So I went to the West Coast. On the way I bought my motorhome. Lived in a motorhome. There is another post and video about that. And went to the West Coast. So what I discovered and thought, so let's start from housing prices. The housing prices in the West Coast are the lowest in New Zealand, one of the lowest. And so they are the lowest in New Zealand. So, for example, a real story of myself buying, wanted probably to buy a house or invest in a house. So, 1,000 square meters land, 4-bedroom, in good quality house, weatherboard, you know, good, it was good inside, partially renovated. Anyway, it was very good, high quality, livable. Same house that in Auckland, in the West Auckland, will cost about $1 million. So the West Coast, 270 for nice land, you know, kind of in Westport, you know. Why not? So, but that is the price that already way high. So it means in January 2020, that the same house costed 180,000. And also when I talking with my colleagues, they bought houses that not really renovated, but for less than 100,000 New Zealand. And you can imagine just in 1 year, the prices in Westport, that town, tripled, even more. Yeah, so you could really buy a house in New Zealand in the West Coast for less than 100,000, but that January 2020. So, and now the houses, it will be quite hard to find the okay house less than 200,000 now, even though it's still cheap, but it will be hard anyway. And so if you're thinking like in a middle kind of class family, super easy to buy a house. Wages are, if you're working in the health sector, super high. You know, doctors can receive already accommodation and a car and a house, you know, if they want to buy as well. But doctors can buy a house very easily in the West Coast and pay it off, I think, in 1 or 2 years. And they always need doctors in there, a huge shortage of doctors. But also other profession, like my profession, you know, I'm a mental health professional, so also really, really needed that. Yeah, so that's regarding housing. Housing there is easy. Today it changed, but I'll talk about it a bit later. And yeah, and also very, very quiet, very dark at night, and like very dark. Like for example, the cities you have like light in the night. Over there, it's almost complete darkness, even with some lighting outside. It's very dark, quiet. So, but then, okay, so you could have a peaceful environment to live, very quiet, not a lot happening. You have some in the main streets, you have some pubs. You have some occasional events that happening. You don't have a lot of places to shop, to do shopping, like you don't have shopping mall. And the nearest place that called city is probably Nelson. It's 3.5 hour drive, about 250 or 300 kilometers, something like that. So quite a drive, but very beautiful drive, but it's quite a drive. So that's what usually people do in Westport. They just go to bigger cities for once in a while to do some shopping. Right? Yeah. And also my workplace, I was living just 2 blocks, so didn't need to commute long, just walk 2 minutes and you're at work. Very easy. And yeah, so very simple life, you know. For example, myself, I could retire there easily. So for example, my wage at work was way higher than most of the population of Westport, because the wages generally they are quite low. So myself, for example, position myself over there financially, super easy. Actually, it was like really easy life, you know, really easy to buy house and also maybe buying few houses and making good investments, you know, financially. And also the beach is very close, so easy life. Could you know, job security also very high. Like in my profession, I think I would definitely will be able to work there until I'll be 65 or 70. Like some of my colleagues, they've been living and working in the same place for 30, 40 years. And yeah, they stay there for their own reasons. So, and this is it. But that's the other part. Doesn't mean that living there is good or bad. It depends what you are looking in life. So, to be honest, for me, I thought it was quite boring. Like, what? That's it? No more challenge? You just go to your nice work and come back to your nice house, and from time to time, I don't know, go for vacation or holidays. But also there'll be more disadvantages over there. So let's talk about work experience. So because I'm working in mental health services around New Zealand, and I've already been in a few areas, including Auckland, Northland, and now the West Coast, and now I'm in different DHB, but so if I'm comparing my work experience, I must say that regards resources and professional development opportunities and challenge at work, it wasn't enough challenging for me compared to other places I've been to. So for a person, let's say, that want to just a simple going to work and not to be too stressed about their work, you know, probably kind of good opportunity, because in Westport people, not all of them work in 5 days. Some people work 2 or 3 days, but of course it's enough, because no, cost of living is quite low. Well, except the food prices are a bit higher, but that's another thing that I wanted to talk about, disadvantages. For me, like, work experience, yeah, it was for a young person who like professional development and a lot of stuff going on and more action, I think it's less suitable. So that's that. Another thing is the weather. Listen, I never lived in a place that it rains so much. It just rains there all year round. Like, I don't know, most of the time. Always rain and heavy, really heavy rain. And for some people it's good. Some people like to collect their own water and they are very happy with a lot of rain, but I prefer to be in sunny places. So this is my preferred weather, especially, you know, after Israel, even in Elat, having this weather all the time, I kind of got used to it and I prefer to be sunny. Of course, not super hot, but sunny at least. So that's that. And yes, the rain, you have plenty of floods, flood zones. You know, you probably heard the flooding that happened last month in Westport that left half of town, houses not suitable for living. Been like low ground and stuff like that, but whoever want to invest in Westport, I can tell them where the good areas and how to buy a house which less percentages will be safe from flooding. Anyway, yeah, so that's the in that area, the weather is basically quite bad. And even in summer, there is a chill wind and it's cold. Like, you can't, I struggle to sit in the sun and just enjoy the sun and tan in Westport. While, for example, in a bit colder place like Christchurch, I doing it a lot more easily because it's, I don't know, it's warmer in the sun. There's no such wind chill like you have in the West Coast. And also you have the Westport and you have Greymouth, that's a bit sulfur. And Greymouth, it's even colder. But they have a new hospital. It's a bit bigger than Westport. But it's kind of the same. But Greymouth actually earned that name, seriously, because it's grey there most of the time. Greymouth? Yeah. So let's say for myself, I had a motorhome and I need to do some fixes and stuff for the motorhome. And I must admit that it went really expensive. Not because somebody was charging me a lot, but because, think about it, you don't have a lot of competition there with mechanics. And there is a lack of professional staff, especially tradespeople, everywhere in New Zealand at the moment. So what happened for me was that for motorhomes, I didn't have where to service my motorhome. So I needed to go to people that generally doing whatever they're doing. And eventually it cost a lot because they didn't do their job properly. And I ended up paying too much money for my motorhome service because I couldn't find the right person. Just give you one example. I asked, I need to install new water heater in my motorhome. And I asked, gas fitter to install my gas heater, you know. And of course said, yeah, no problem, I will install it. I did a lot of times worked like that. Eventually what he did partial work and wanted to charge me $700 for incomplete job. And also he came and threatened me for not paying him while he didn't do what he promised. Which was completely ridiculous. And also regards mechanics. I paid them for the service, they do partial service, and then they can close or disappear, or another thing, you can go to a mechanic and pay for something and they will invent some issues that not exist just to rip you off another $2,000. Because they have a motorhome, of course you can afford to pay it. Anyway, so my conclusion was, place that is cheap is very expensive. So it wasn't really cheap. Of course, it depends what your needs. Of course, if you don't need motorhome, or if you sit in just work home, doing nothing, probably it's a good place. But I found, yeah, not really. Yeah. So, regards social. So, even though they're saying community is nice and helping each other and everything, myself as an immigrant, Russian immigrant, I didn't really feel the fit. So people there are very local, living there for many, many years, even though now the population will be changing, so more people who are retiring, moving there. So what's happened, they sold their houses in Oakland for millions and they bought a house for 200,000 in Westport and they have 1.8 million for retirement, do whatever. So now the environment is changing, so I can't say I had amazing social life over there, even though I had some friends over there, but not much happened. No. Anyway, so all these things, you know, like I did my answers. I got my answers about the West Coast. I know my impression. I have a lot of experience and I know exactly what this place is after a year. And mission complete. So I have nothing to do there anymore. So that's why I left. Went next. That's why. But I definitely regret it, because living in the West Coast made me appreciate some other things, and I learned this conclusion. Cheap can become very expensive. So in some areas you pay less, but in other areas you pay a lot. And for conclusion, weather wise, if you like being in rain and cold most of the year, could be nice. If you want to kind of stay away from people, be like really in your own life, you know, West Coast is great. For a person that want more, more vibrant, in New Zealand terms more vibrant, not in European or Central America or Asian terms more vibrant. In New Zealand terms, yeah, like this is not the most vibrant place. Has really nice nature and a lot of walks, but all New Zealand has all these nice walks and nice places in nature. Everywhere you have these places. So I really want to say that for some people it's will be really suitable to live in the West Coast. For others, not really. And of course, if you want to move to New Zealand, then think where it's better to live. Please feel free to contact me. I'll give you a consultation. I've been living a few places already in New Zealand. And also I know what are the crime rates and the social status and where is good and bad and all these things. And I continue to do so. That's what I'm doing for many years. And I will find the right suitability for you if the West Coast is the good place for you, or maybe other place will be a lot better for you. So that's my impression. If you have any questions or if you want to know more, so please let me know.